Hello and welcome to Technically You, the place for future technologists. I am Professor Brandy Yu. If you are new to our channel, hit the subscribe button during this session. Today on Technically You, we will be covering software-defined perimeter. What is a software-defined perimeter, SDP? A software-defined perimeter, SDP, is a method of concealing your infrastructure that is connected to the internet, such as routers and servers, by preventing external users from being able to see it. As a result, the infrastructure is utterly invisible to unauthorized users. An SDP establishes virtual boundaries around internet-connected assets and user activity through an integrated security architecture approach at the network layer. SDP works regardless of whether assets reside on-premises or in the cloud or whether users are on-site or working remotely. Rather than relying on hardware like firewalls or VPNs at the network boundary, SDP leverages software to prevent access to or even visibility into resources within the virtual perimeter by default. This deny-all approach only grants access through mutual authentication of authorized users and validated devices attempting connection. Internet-connected resources protected by the SDP architecture remain otherwise hidden to everyone and everything else. SDP makes it possible to take the principle of least privilege to its logical conclusion through much more tightly defined micro-segmentation of resources. SDP gates access on a one-to-one connection basis rather than an IP basis to account for the broad distribution of assets in cloud environments. So, SDP access is granted to specific resources rather than a network at large, which means that only those who absolutely need to use specific resources to perform their jobs are allowed access. While it might still be wise to use firewalls for internal segmentation to limit the reach of malware, SDP technology supplants many of its traditional protection benefits. While traditional security is centralized in public or private data centers, SDP is everywhere, delivered by the cloud, and uses business policy to determine who gets access to resources. SDP distributes access to internal applications based on a user's identity and with trust that adapts based on context. SDPs are 100% software defined and built on a need-to-know model, with trust that is constantly monitored and adjusted based on a range of criteria. Since SDP makes application infrastructure invisible to the internet, it protects against network-based attacks such as DDoS, ransomware, malware, server scanning, and more. The adoption of SDP technology has grown as organizations seek to modernize their application security with zero-trust security. How does a software-defined perimeter work? A software-defined perimeter prevents illegitimate users and devices from accessing certain parts of the network and from getting inside the network itself. To accomplish this, the system uses zero-trust security, what is often referred to as a black cloud approach, named so because it makes the network behind it black or invisible, and the principle of authentication first and access afterwards. In other words, zero trust assumes that every person or device is malicious, so they must prove their identity. How do you set up a software-defined perimeter, SDP? To set up a software-defined perimeter, you must first verify the identity of the user. This can be done using multi-factor authentication, MFA, single sign-on, SSO, or other methods, such as Security Assertion Markup Language, SAML. The next step is to verify the security of the device. The device will be checked to versioning, malware infections, and if it is allowed. The final step is to open the SDP gateway to allow user passage after ensuring the data transmitted during the connection is protected via secure tunnels between the device and the user's services. SDP always creates a separate encrypted network connection for each user. The four core principles that differentiate SDP technologies from traditional security applications are 1. Trust is never implicit. Traditional network security offers excessive trust to its users. Trust must be earned. SDPs only grant application access to authenticated and specifically authorized users to use that app. Furthermore, these authorized users are only granted access to the application, not the network. 2. No inbound connections. Unlike a virtual private network, VPN, which listens for inbound connections, SDPs receive no inbound connections. By responding with outbound-only connections, Both network and application infrastructure is kept invisible or cloaked to the internet and therefore impossible to attack. 3. Application segmentation, not network segmentation. In the past, organizations had to perform complex network segmentation to limit a user's ability to move laterally once on the network. While this approach worked well enough, it was never granular and required constant maintenance. SDP has native application segmentation that can control access down to a one-to-one basis. The result is far more granular segmentation that is much easier for the IT or security team. 4. Leveraging the internet securely. Organizations need to shift away from a network-centric focus with users everywhere and applications moving outside the public or private data center. Security must change to where your users are, which means leveraging the internet as your new corporate network. SDP is focused on securing user-to-application connections over the internet rather than securing the user's access to the network. From an architectural standpoint, SDP differs fundamentally from network-centric solutions. SDPs are 100% software-defined, eliminating the enterprise overhead of deploying and managing appliances. The adoption of SDP also leads to simplifying the inbound stack as organizations complement or eliminate the requirements for VPN, DDoS protection, global load balancing, and firewall appliances. Thank you for watching our video on SDP. We appreciate you spending time with us. If you like this or any other Technically You video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel.